In the training pyramid that you see that a lot of the European masters use, in your classical, more traditional riders, they have a pyramid that's a training pyramid in it. I'll see if I can get a copy of it and add to this video, but it's a stages that you prepare a horse to be ridden. And one of the things on the first level of that pyramid is relaxation. And this is something that is very important. And when you're preparing this horse to be ridden and to be used, if he's not relaxed, if you're not relaxed, nobody's getting anywhere. So what I encourage you all to do is bring your horse out here and work with him in a way that, as you can see, I mean, you could live in New York City and never seen a horse in your life, but you can look at this horse and say he's relaxed, okay? I mean, his eyes are soft and his body's supple and he's not anxious or nervous, okay? So part of that is going to be accomplished through us just taking him on the end of the rope and turning him like this, doing things. You know, I'm going to take his stick and I'm going to touch him in all different places of his body. I'm going to ask him to step over, away from pressure, like this. So if there's anywhere I touch him on his body that he flinches or he gets anxious about, then I know I got to stop and condition that area of his body. But, you know, all these videos are probably unimportant unless I emphasize the importance of you developing relaxation in your horse, you being relaxed. And I've heard it said that there's some things that can't be taught, they have to be learned. Well, this is one of them, that, you know, you can read 100 books about different things, but you need to get out here with your horse and get him on the end of this line and be creative. Think about, what can I do to make him relaxed, to develop relaxation, to get him to where when I pick my hand up, he doesn't pull away. He's not afraid of me. And he respects me. He respects my space, but he's relaxed. And so if something happens or he sees something he doesn't like, he's not going to respond fearfully. He's not going to bolt, or he's not going to buck, or he's not going to get resistive to what's going on. So that's why when I tell people, you have no idea how many hundreds of hours go into these horses to get them that way. But part of that is just doing what we're doing right here today, just standing here beside him calmly, and get him to where he trusts us. I'd say less than half of what we do is mounted. You know, we're working continuously on just getting these horses to where they can be used safely and they can be usable in a way where you can enjoy them. Most trainers just want to climb on their back and zing around in a bunch of circles and beat on them with a crop to get their leads right and so on. Well, you know, you skipped a lot of steps to get that done, and that's why there's a lot of half-done horses in this world nobody wants, okay? So I'm going to put a copy of that chart on this video for you to look at. I think it's important that you study that, and then, and as we start moving forward, now we're going to get into some more mounted work. But I think that this is a good subject to discuss before we do that, so you understand the importance of relaxation. Thank you.